Hey everyone, welcome to the farm. I've been talking about it for a while, that we're gonna get outside, we're gonna try some bikes out, and here we are. And the farm, the reason behind it, it's my parents' place. They've been here for over 30 years. This is where I grew up back in these fields, riding dirt bikes, where I learned, cut my teeth at riding dirt bikes. And everybody's got their unique story, and this is kind of where we grew up, me and my brothers, and grew a passion for the sport. Today we're out here, behind me, we got a gas machine, as well as the Yamaha machine. They're both 450s. They're both stock. Besides the graphics from M7, we got the fully kitted one for the Yamaha, as well as just some number plates for the gas. So we're gonna test these out today. The one thing about the gas, it's kind of making a comeback now since purchased by KTM, the Austria brand. It used to be a Spanish brand. Now it's gonna be Austrian made, and very similar to the KTM model. We've seen Sam Gainer and Steve Sims talk about it last week or 2 weeks ago. And then the Yamaha, the Japanese model. These guys have been around for a while. A little bit different setup on these Yamahas. They got the reverse motor. So the intake is at the front, and it comes out with a different power. We've actually got a little bit of testing on it, but we're gonna go head to head today, and we're gonna report back to you guys on how each of these bikes handle. And the track we're gonna ride today is a hard pack clay track. So it's a little bit different than say a Gopher Dunes, where it's very sandy, silty, even a Walton when it's turned up. It's gonna be very flat and smooth. So good for us vet riders, our older class, that we don't need too many suspension trick outs or whatnot. We can just ride the stock motorcycle and it'll be good to go. But I'm gonna go suit up. Join me at the track. All right, there you have it. We had a nice little ride day. I'd like to talk about the gas bike right off the hop here. And after putting a few laps in it, and you could tell by the video that the track's a little drier, a little slippery. It's a practice track. And right off the hop, the gas seemed like it sticked to the ground real well. One adjustment, you know, for any rider that's come from the Japanese bike background, like a Yamaha, Honda, Kawasaki, is the hydraulic clutch. And that's something that KTM's brought in. You can get them for the other bikes, but this thing comes stock with it. And it's one thing, it feels different. You don't have that play that you're used to in the cable, the slack. And it's just a nice smooth feel. So it's actually nice once you get used to it. It's just different when you start. The power on the gas is very tame. It's nice for the hard packed surface. I'm not sure how it would be in the sand. You kind of want a little bit more torque through the sand, but on this hard pack track, that is a good feature, especially for my riding ability. I'm an ex-pro vet rider now. I just like to go out, ride a nice smooth bike, and not have to worry about those, you know, big jumps and stuff like that, those big kickers. Just ride a nice smooth track, and this is a perfect little setup for it. A couple other things I noticed. I haven't had much background in the air fork. I know they've tried it on other bikes. The gas has it here. And honestly, it felt good, very plush. It handled some of the smaller stuff real well. We didn't have much big stuff out there, so it'd be a test at another track to see how it handled the bigger bumps. But for that track, it felt great. Another thing I noticed right off the hop was the foot pegs. Very sharp foot pegs on it, and it made my feet stick to them and easier through those whoop sections. I was able to kind of get on my toes and get through those without losing my grip. But all in all, gas, first impression on the hard pack track, I liked it. I think it's a very vet friendly bike, as well as you can be aggressive with it as a pro rider. You know, coming from that KTM, Husky, now gas background, the bikes are all similar. And you see the top guys in Canada, like a Jess Pettis, Cole Thompson, now Sam Gainer, and some Husky guys like Keelan Meston, they all succeed on these bikes. And you can see why. It's a very comfortable fit right off the hop. Now we jump to the YZ 450. And one cool feature right off the hop is before you even get on this thing, it's got the app, and you can see how you can download maps, you can change the things, you can just see your actual run time, your oil change time, your piston time, and keep track of a log of things. So right off the hop, before you even get on this bike, that's a cool feature. And you know, being a stats guy, I love numbers. It's huge. It's a, you know what I mean, get around on the phone, okay, I put 7 hours on this, I gotta get this oil changed. You know, I put 15 hours, I gotta get this piston changed. So very cool feature right off the hop. Then you jump on the bike. It's got the different settings right on the, it's got the launch control on one side, but it's got the two maps you can put in the other side. So we went with a slippery surface map as well as a bit of a hard hitting one. But for me as a vet rider, the hard hitting one, I didn't want to touch out there. It's a hard slippery track. I just went with the smooth mapping. And right off the hop, from the gas to the YZ, it has a lot of power. It's a lot more snappier on the bottom end. Not so much on the top, it smooths out on the top. But for me, I want that smooth transition. It might have been just a little bit too snappy. I got used to it as we went along. But yeah, just switching from the gas to the YZ, it was just a little snappier. More of a pro rider, like a supercross bottom end. But that's things you can adjust. You can adjust that through your, you know, your mapping on your phone, as well as you can do it with your gearing. So a couple adjustments there. The next thing, the spring fork. So we just did the air fork with the gas. Honestly, the spring fork, it just sat a little higher in the stroke, I felt like. It's not adjusted for me, but this is right out of the box. You can ride this thing and feel comfortable right out of the box. And yeah, the spring fork, maybe if I adjusted those a little bit and made it to my weight, it'd be perfect, but it sat a little high for me. Going on is the noise. You can hear the suction. I talked about the backwards motor. You can actually hear the suction. It's right in front of you, and it's, I don't mind it. You don't notice it so much, but it's like coming from a gas, going to that, you can kind of just a little bit of suction noise there. All in all, the YZ, right out of the box, very fast, nothing needed to be done, no pipes, no anything, as well as the gas. They're both bikes that you can just jump on and race from the pro level to the vet level and to the beginner level. All in between. It's you know, both bikes great. The Japanese, we talked about the hydraulic clutch on the gas. The Japanese bikes come with that cable, and that's more what I grew up with, so I felt comfortable right away. Others, little differences that you notice, the braking systems are a little bit different from the Austrian bike to the Japanese bike. But honestly, all in all, these bikes, I could jump back and forth all day long, and it's got their differences, but man, definitely fun bikes to ride. It'd be interesting to try them in some sandy soil. So maybe upcoming, we get to Gopher Dunes and we test these out in that rough sand. So like I said, these are right out of the crate stock. The only thing on this Yamaha is we got that full M7 kit. Obviously we want to show off all our partners, all our sponsors. And that's the cool thing about graphics. The, you know, the gas model, we just put number plates on it. But this one, we got all the partners on there, and that's for any rider coming up. You get a partner, get a sponsor, you want to put them on their graphics, hit up M7, those guys dial you in. But what we're going to do is we're going to come back to the track more throughout these episodes, and we're going to try parts on these things. They're stock right now, maybe try exhaust system, maybe try some different bars, some grips, whatever it be. But Parts Canada supplying us with all the goods, and they want us to try out some of the products that they supply to their dealers all across Canada, as well as this Thor gear I'm wearing right here. This is my first time riding with this Thor gear, and it fits and finished perfect. Loved it right out of the box. So like the Yamaha, like the gas, we're gonna try some parts on these things and just see how, you know, we can make it and manipulate it into maybe a more bike that suits different people, and we can talk about that and just see what these parts actually do for the motorcycle.